Good morning, students. Hope you are able to solve the given homework in our last videos. Now today we have discussed some more questions and in the size 8A. Now we are going to discuss question number 7 onward. In question number 7, it is given. First, let me read the question. By selling a basket of mangoes for rupees 105, our fruit seller loss is 30%. First, in this question is given that your selling price, your loss percentage. Then again question asked to you, for how much should he sell to gain 40%? How much should he sell to gain 40%? In previous there is a loss of 30%. Then question asked to you about gaining of 40%. Let's start. First, write down what is given in the question. It is your selling price rupees 105, loss percentage is your 30%. So what is your CP? From that formula we know that CP equals to SP into 100 by 100 minus loss percent. Find out the CP first. SP is given 105 into 100 minus 100 minus loss percent is given. We did not write 30%, we only write the numeric part, only 30. 105 into 100 by 70. So it is not multiplied, leave as it is. This is your cost price for the one basket of mango. Now next part says that in this is your CP, this is your now question asked you in selling price. So selling price for the next part, selling price, new selling price equals to, we must know the formula. In new SP we have to gain or profit percent equals to 40%. So new SP equals to CP into 100. CP into 100. In this case we have profit, so 100 plus profit percent is whole upon by 100. Now find out. First, place these well. If you want to simplify, you can simplify but not remove the fraction. It's a 1050/7. Now come to that part. CP equals to 1050/7 into in bracket 100 plus profit percent, that is your 40 upon 100. When we simplify, 1050 into it's a 140 by 7 into 100. First we remove the 0 from 7, then 7 2's are, it's a rupees 210. This is your solution of question number 7. First, we from the given thing, we try to find out the CP. We will not solve because it makes you fall, it fail you, it's give you trouble when we solve that question. So leave as it is. Now in next part it's given that profit percent equals to 40%. Then from the formula we can easily find out the selling price, new selling price. One more interesting question is question number 8. First read the question. Question says that a man sold a book at a loss of 20%. If he sold that book rupees 12 more, then he would have gained 10%. Find the cost price of the book. Here question asked you cost price. So first write down, suppose let CP equals to X. CP equals to X. Now question says that first he sold at 20% loss. So selling price is equals to X plus, sorry, there is loss, so X minus first item formula. Selling price equals to CP minus loss percent, because SP is greater than smaller, in this case SP is smaller than CP. So it's a X minus 20% of X. It's a X minus 20/100 X. When we simplify, as we discussed in class 7, 100 1 the 100, 100 X minus 20 X, it's 80 X upon 100. This is your first selling price. Now question says that if he sells, he sold 12 more, then he would have gained 10%. In second case, this is first part. In second part, question says that there is a gain of 10% or profit percent, both is same, 10%. So selling price is equals to CP plus profit or gain, they are same, profit percent. So it's a X plus, it's a 10% of X, and it's a 10/100 into X. It's a 110x/100. Now this is a condition part. Condition says that if he sells at this, at 12 more than this price, then he must have profit, add profit to this one. So according to question, ATX/100 plus 12 equals to 110x/100. Simplify them. 12 equals to 10x/100 minus 80x/100. The numerator is same, so you can easily write down 30x/100. This minus this 12. Then 12 into 100 by 30 equals to X. Cancels each other. 3 4, sir. It's a 40 equals to X. The CP of book equals to rupees 40. This is your answer. Now, students, we are going to discuss the next question, that is your question number 9. So let us read what is the interesting part of this question. A trader sells 2 cycles at rupees 1188 each, gaining 10% on first cycle and losing 10% on the second cycle. Find the total loss or profit percent in the whole transaction. So it's the easiest one, but some of you say that's the toughest one. Let's try and see whether it's toughest. It's the longest one, but if you do the step by step, you can easily solve this one. In first, we know that SP of one cycle equals to rupees 1188. Two cycle equals to, or can say total SP. There are two cycle, total SP equals to 2376 rupees. This is your total SP. Now, in first cycle he gained 10% and in second he lose 10%. Let CP equals to X. So on first cycle there is a profit percent equals to 10%. If profit percent is 10, CP is X. So what is SP? SP, as we know, that it's 1188. So we can easily write down SP equals to CP into 100 plus K percent of profit percent. I am always writing alternate way. So that you can easily understand what is K percent, what is profit percent. They are same. So it's upon 100. What is CP? It's a X 100 plus 10% in 10 upon 100. It's a 110x upon 100. And it is given that first cycle is rupees 1188. So therefore we can find out x from here. 1188 into 100 by 1080 rupees is the cost price for each cycle. Now in first cycle we have 1080 is the cost of first cycle. Then come to the second cycle. Let's check whether it's a CP is same or not. There is a loss percent equals to 10%. There is a loss of 10%. So again we can say CP equals to Y. This is say that CP equals to Y, and suppose this one. Now from in second cycle I am using the word SP equals to CP, then 100 minus loss percent upon 100. It's equals to CP is your Y, 100 minus 10 by 100, and this one is same 1188. You press that. Now we leave this all 1188 equals to 90 Y upon 100. 1188 into 100 by 90. This is equals to Y. Cancels. Try to solve this by 9. Whether it's nil or not, check it. Now, as I solve rough, it's a 1 3 2. So cost is 1 3 2 0. This is your cost price of second cycle. It's a 1 3 2 0. Now we have cost price of first cycle and cost price of second cycle. Let's solve whether it is a profit or loss. I am rubbing this side because there is no more space. can rewind the video to note down the question. So you can total SP B is known as 2376. Total CP equals to in previous it's a 1080 and now it's a 1320. Total CP is your 1400. Sorry, 2400. So there is a loss because CP is greater than SP. So loss equals to 2400 minus 2376. It's a near about 24 rupees. So loss percentage 24 upon 2400 into 100. percent loss. Now we are going to discuss question number 12, that last question of this exercise. I hope you are able to complete A exercise today itself. Now read the question. A man buys a plot of agricultural land for ₹3,60,000. He sells one third it at a loss of 20% and rest of two fifths at a gain of 25%. At what price must he sell the remaining profit so as to take an overall profit of 10%? Let's solve it. So let's start the solution of question number 12. In this question, again the CP of complete land equals to 3,60,000. This is your CP given to you. Now it says that for first one third plot, there is a loss of almost 30%. Okay, loss is 20%, so SP equals to, I feel the thing, that's why I pause the video. It's as we know that CP 100 from list, I don't know if I got from that, it is understood to you. Right now, but here CP of one third, we must find out it's a 3,60,000 by 3, it's equal to 1,20,000. We must find out this one. CP of one third plot is 1,20,000 into 100 plus 20% upon 100. Sorry, there is loss, not use plus sign, minus sign, I forgot. It's a 1,20,000 into 80 upon 100. It's 96,000. This is your first SP. You must remember. Then we are going to next part of question. It says that 2/5 plot. So you must write down for 2/5 plot. What is the CP of that 2/5 plot? It's 3,60,000 into 2/5. When you simplify this, 5 2s are 30, 5 4s is 24,000. sorry, it's 36,000, 5 7 jar and 5 2 jar. It's 1,44,000 is your CP. Now, so as we know, in this case, gain percent equals to 25%. So gain percent is 25%. Therefore, another way to write the formula: SP equals to CP. It's 1,44,000. Into it's 100 plus 25%. It's 1,80,000. This is your second SP. Second SP. Now, then question say asked you that how many amount he sells the remaining plot so that he gain profit, 10% profit on overall transaction. So, for complete plot, profit equals to 10% SP equals to CP. It's a 3,60,000 100 plus 10, so 10 plus 10 upon 100. Ultimately, when you multiply this one, we have it's a 3,96,000. This is your selling price. But question asked you that in how many amount he sells the remaining plot to receive this profit. So let me rub the board. I am rubbing back to this one because you can easily understand what is the first selling price. Now, in this case, we have CP 3 lakh, we have CP 3,60,000, we have total SP 3,96,000. So, what is the selling price of the remaining part? SP of remaining plot is, first we subtract 3,96,000 minus this first selling price 96,000 minus the second selling price 1,80,000. But we have this minus this, we have 3 lakh minus we have 1,20,000. This is the selling price of the remaining plot. That's all for your this exercise. You have to solve all the questions. Almost most of the questions solved by me, discussed by me, but rest of you solve by yourself. Need not to take any other person's help. Do by yourself so that you can improve your knowledge. Thank you.